Welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In this series, we are seeing the stateflow and concept of stateflow. Today, we will see what is flowchart and how to create a flowchart in MATLAB stateflow. So to create a stateflow, we need to type sf again. We will save this particular model with the name stateflow flowchart. As you can see on the left hand side, the model got created. Now let's double click on this model. Let's enter inside the stateflow chart. Suppose I want to create a stateflow chart, then I need to use some junctions and some transitions. So let's create a flow in the flowchart in stateflow. In this tutorial, we will see how to create a if condition in a flowchart from scratch. The circle that you are able to see on the screen is called a junction, and this one is the default transition as we have seen on the last tutorial. Now, suppose I want one more junction and again one more junction, and I will be connecting the junctions, and at the end I will be having one more junction. As you can see on the screen, we have created a state flowchart in which we have a default transition, one junction followed by two more junctions, and at the end one more junction at the end. In state flow for flowchart, this is the starting junction and this is the ending junction. We are getting two transitions from one junction, and we are able to see some numbers over here. As we have two transitions, then we got this number. For other junction who has only one transition coming in or out, has no numbers mentioned like this. So what is basically this number is? This is the priority of transition. If the priority is less, then that transition will happen. In this case, we are having two unconditional transitions, so this will make a conflict which transition to take. So basically, in flowchart or in stateflow also, we need one unconditional transition and remaining conditional transitions. So in this case, I will be mentioning x greater than 10 will be my condition for this particular transition. Now the yellow part disappeared. Now I need to define some operations based on the condition that I have mentioned over here. So in this case, what I will be having is like, if x is greater than 10, then add 1 to y equal to y plus 1. This will be my condition. If x is smaller than equal to 10, then increment y equal to y plus 2. So this is the condition that I will be making with the help of this flowchart. If x is greater than 10, then I will be adding y equal to y plus 1. If x is smaller than or equal to 10, then I will be adding 2 to the y variable. So let's define this. So when x is greater than 10, then I will be following this path. The basic flow of flowchart happens from top to bottom, starting from this junction. So from this junction, it will try to identify which path it needs to take, and then it will follow the same into the next junction as well. So in this case, the x is greater than 10 is satisfied, suppose, then it will increment y in curly braces. This will be the output, y equal to y plus 1. This will be the output. And if this is not satisfied, which is the second condition, then in this case, output will be y equal to y plus, and we will reach to the end with this particular line into the flowchart end. Now let's simulate this flowchart and see what error we are getting. Now we got some error. Let's see the symbol widget. It is showing that suggestions what variable should be, which we have defined in the flowchart. Here we have defined x as well as y. So based on that, it has suggested that x could be